That's a shitty question, so I'm not gonna answer it.
That's a stupid question. my Plenty of Fish got taken down.
Good.
You know, it's just our heat.
It's pretty funny.
That are hidden,
and then,
right?
And then I tried signing up with a new one out of curiosity to see what would happen, and it instantly got taken down.
Do not use them. Approach the hull in
like
these
instantly.
Access achieved. We may proceed.
Wow.
Racist. He just learned you good, Joker, okay?
Has little aerogravity. Geth require neither.
Have either of you guys been with a trap or a tranny?
Thanks, Nate Stewart Games.
Won't we be detected?
Why did it get taken down? I actually don't know. But then again, like, here's the thing. I advertise my Plenty of Fish to, like, everyone. So it could have taken one guy to go, heh heh heh. Like, James the Goat. Probably. Yeah, now it's James the Goat. Like, somebody could have just went, heh heh, I'll report him. And that's all it takes. And, I think Plenty of Fish seems to have, like, one of those things that, like, if you get... Oh, by the way, like...
You're also a shit poster.
Yeah, but on that site, I try... Like, I shit post even on Plenty of Fish. But the thing is like, I keep it well within the means of, like, that site. Like, I don't think I was breaking any rules.
You're also a white male.
Here's the thing. There's an actual gender bias on Plenty of Fish.
Dude.
If you're a male, you actually can't swear or use certain words. You can't say... boobs, tits, or any swear words or anything. You actually are unable to send messages.
What?
If you write any of that shit, but women can say anything they want on that site. So if I write,
I would like to see more to that.
Excuse me. I had to deal with that every single day.
I know. I created a fake POF account as a woman too. I've never tested those things out.
Well, make a fake one with a man. As a male, and then try and write somebody a message with the word ass or tits in it. Just that's it. And then, copy and paste it, and you'll see that the message didn't send. Try it again and just remove that word, the ass or the tits or whatever word that you used, and it will send. It actually will censor you, and, it will keep you from sending a message if you say any, bad words. And then a female can do it, and they can say whatever the fuck they want, they're uncensored. It's really fucking stupid. It took some bad... The only way I found that out was, I noticed, some of my messages weren't sending. And then, because I just kept saying, ass, like, wanna see him, show me that cake. And, the message wouldn't send. And I was having a back-and-forth conversation with this girl, and she's... She was just like... Yeah, your last message didn't send, and I sent her what I said... but, modified it just in case to see if, I was being censored. And, it worked. It's like, this is what I said. And then I just told her straight up. It's like, and I put it in quotations. Like, all I said was, ass or something. And then she's laughing. She's like, dude, I can say whatever the fuck I want. And then it sent. She said the word fuck. And it was like, wow. Okay. Why? It's stupid. Why is it that men get censored on that site? If you think it's something to do with harassment or
I knew it.
If it has something to do with harassment and constantly messaging girls, I'm sure it's very one-sided too, for the most part. But that doesn't mean that, women aren't incapable of being show me that dick. Hey, buddy, show me that dick. Peer pressuring. Whatever. It's just weird in one side.
Shut up, Garrus.
I'm picking up useful resources in the Geth hubs. We could salvage them for supply.
Why are all the heretics attached to these hubs?
These are mobile platforms.
There is like a 2-to-1 ratio of people, like men to women, on Plenty of Fish 2. So there's like an overabundance of men.
Of course there is.
Not as many girls.
Because girls don't have to do anything to get laid or find a boyfriend or.
It's true.
Really?
Yep. In fact, they just complain about all the offers. Oh,
data,
somebody complimented me today. Harassment. Oh my god. I would love it if somebody harassed me for once. not you, Jackie Chan. You stay away. Keep away from my boy pussy. No touch. Whoosh.
One platform will see things, another does not, and will make different judgments.
I don't hate niggers. I love all niggers.
If that's the case, is rewriting.
Flying Oblivion said it. I'm allowed. I've been anointed by black people to say that word. I have the proof. I have the screenshots.
Took their perspective.
I should archive them. So I can whip them out.
I don't think you're missing much.
That one day on Instagram when, like,
even those that are wrong,
when black people anointed me with the power to say that word.
For example,
that was pretty funny.
We found the casual self-deceptions of organics useful in analyzing your thought processes.
I like this.
Let's keep moving.
Yes. We can assume control of any defensive turret. They will assist us by attacking your target.
I would actually love to see, like, some stereotypical, like, white girl unironically, like, try to defend herself or, like, not sound like a racist and be like, no, 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 I love niggers! Like, that would be really funny. Like some Max Caulfield looking white bread. See, I can be racist to white people too.
Hax Caulfield.
Yeah. Oh, that one girl we were hanging out with, which I won't name. I mentioned that, I mentioned being pretentious enough to walk around with a Blu-ray camera, like, in 2016. I was like, I compared, like, I said something about, like, being as, like, pretentious as, like, that, or, you know, stupid. And then they immediately said, oh, I have a Polaroid camera. I was like,
that's so funny.
Also,
that's why Life is Strange is a very popular game, is because it directly speaks to these people.
I'm not a Trump supporter, I'm an anti-Hillary supporter. No, you're right. Adam, I think I know a thing or two about this. I went to school for psychology. But it's the worst. It's to the point where, like, you literally can't take anyone seriously the second they bust out the, oh, I went to school for psychology, so that means I'm smart.
And to clarify, it wasn't them mentioning it. It was them using it as a valid proof for how they know what other people are thinking.
Yes.
Like, literally, yes. What we've already made fun of on this stream before, except in real life.
And that's the amazing part. It was like all our worst
borderline parody.
Yeah, it was like a walking parody. We ran into a walking parody like the other day, and I literally cracked a joke as like, oh yeah, me and my white privilege, and then this person went on like an actual tangent going, no, actually, you do have white privilege. Also male privilege. It was like, I went to school for the colored arts, and you are a bad man. Me as we. Why are you taking psychology? I just... Can I... What purpose are... Like, unless you're actually... Unless you were, like, full-blown, yes, I want to become a psychiatrist. Why does anybody go to school for psychology? Seriously. You want to study the human mind? Interact with them. Talk to them. Talk to a wide variety of people. You'll start to see, like...
It's not about understanding the human mind. It's about being able to hold up a certificate that you can prove to other people that you understand the human mind.
Yeah, that's why...
That's all it's about. It's not about actually understanding or learning.
I know. And that's why I fucking hate post-secondary or college or university. It's just like, everyone... Like, I love my family, but they're constantly pressuring me to go to film school. They're like, oh, if you love it, then spend the, like, 40 grand and just do it. It's like, yeah, nah. Like, I've said before that if I just, like, somebody threw the money at me, I would definitely go to college. Just because I think it would be fun and it would be a great hands-on experience. But I wouldn't do it for the diploma. Not so that I have a fucking piece of paper that says, I can do good. Like, I hate that. I hate that that's, like, expected of everybody, that that's just, like, how the...
Well, yeah, it's not the issue that colleges are bad, it's that, like, the expectation of people thinking that that's something, that's, like, just a stepping stone in your life, and that you should go to college even if you don't know what you really want to be doing with your life. That's why people wind up taking psychology, is because it's like, well, I'm in college now, and I gotta study something.
Yeah, I know. Like,
I've been told that now is the point in my life where I have to pick one of these predetermined options, even if none of them actually fit me. Even if, like, literally this isn't, none of these things are things that I want to be doing. But I'll get credits, and then I'll have spent thousands upon thousands of dollars on this piece of paper that doesn't actually get me anywhere. Unless you actually know what you're studying, and actually have a plan before you get into college.
The worst part,
like, 80% of college, I'm making up numbers, obviously.
Yeah.
But I mean, like, 80% of college students just show up and start college before they actually know what they want to be doing with their lives.
Yeah.
That's fucked up.
Yeah.
That's not how you do it.
There's no, why is there such a rush to go to college? Like, we like,
I know.
You can apply at any age. There's no age restriction. It's like, I'm okay with going to college at like 50, if that's what it takes. Like, and it's, if it's something I really believe in, I believe that I need. Here's the thing is like, I've studied so much about film online that I think textbook-wise, I think I already know everything that I need to know about, like, shooting and cameras and, like, in general. I just need the practical, like, tests. I need, like, to work with, like, actors, and I need to, like, be on set. I need the camera work and everything.
We're not saying that the concept of psychology has no value or that learning psychology has no value.
It's a default.
It's just one of those stupid, easy. Is that categorized in, like, social sciences?
Oh God.
Or is that
maybe?
It's just the notoriously known. I have no idea what I'm doing, but I'm going to pick a course anyway. Course. It's like we're talking about people who take psychology without having any plans whatsoever to use that in their degree or use that in their actual profession. And a lot of these people are just plain obnoxious.
To assume I'm smart because I took psychology.
I've met way too many fucking people who take a course or have a degree in a psychology-related field, like psychology, psychotherapy, you name it, whatever. I've met way too many fucking people who will use that as a justification for saying that you shouldn't be allowed to question them, or say, like, it's their default, well, I'm the expert here, and so nothing that you say matters after that point. It's like, oh, well, I can see exactly why you've taken it then.
Yeah.
I can see exactly why you took psychology, and so you can say that shit.
Yeah.
Right? It's awful.
So there's really nothing wrong with psychology itself.
Yeah,
it's the, like, stupid people that are taking it, and, like, for such useless reasons.
I died.
There's plenty of people getting into like every course that is available at like university or college or post-secondary that are filled with idiots that are like, or filled with people that like shouldn't be there or don't like, or just there cuz there's no reason. It's I have to go to college to impress my family, and I will take this because it seems easy, or this because I guess I kind of like it. I want to go to this college to be smart. I'll take psychology. That makes sense. That makes me a smart boy. It's stupid. Like, that idea alone. Like, you should really, like, get into it if you're willing to go all the way.
So if there was a graph of, like, how easy a course was versus how smart people thought they were after taking the course, like, psychology would be on the extreme end of the graph, right?
Yeah.
Versus, like, actual... you know, actual intelligence or any kind of mental effort, like engineering or, you know, any kind of, like, mathematical course. Or like, you know, physics or...
Yeah, I know. It's,
I fucked up. No! No, I'm gonna die again! Oh, I screwed up.
I screwed up.
Should have done that after.
I screwed it up. Na, na, na. Are you a clever boy?
It's like I'm basing my opinions on it based on the amount of people I've run into who are just the most insufferable, like, conceited, self-loving,
David
like
Cage.
It's and what's the worst part about it is like, if you were seriously interested in how the human brain works, and if you were seriously interested in, you know, using that as an application to better your own life and not just talk down on other people, then at no point would you say, this is an excuse that I can stop questioning myself. A person who actually gives a shit about the human brain and how it works would never come to the point where they say, this is where I stop questioning myself. Like, that's one of the most basic principles you should have if you understand anything about the human brain.
Yeah. Oh, what button do I press, like, to change this
menu?
So I can actually see? Menu? Where is menu? Oh, there we go.
Enter. Yeah. Native.
Oh, sweet. Mm. I can watch it old school. Native, there we go. Exit. Sweet, thank you. Just realized part of the screen was cut off.
It never saves the settings, unfortunately.
Yeah. Oh well, what can you do?
I don't know why.
I mean, you got this, like, from my understanding. Well, actually, that TV, that big, what is it? A Sony.
The Bravia?
The Sony is, like, the TV that's amazing that you got, like, for super cheap. Though this Toshiba, it's not bad, and I imagine you got about the same way. So, I mean, what can you do? Like, how much can you complain about it? Like, a cheap, good TV?
Yeah, I had that TV before I even moved here. Yeah. And I actually went over to a friend's house who has that exact same TV, the exact same size and everything. And theirs is starting to really crap out on them, too, and do, like, really weird things. Just, like, for absolutely no reason.
Yeah.
And it makes me wonder if it's just one of those built-to-fail sort of, oh, it's been X amount of years, you gotta break now, things that they put into technology, which is very real and awful.
Yep. It used to be a thing that, like, we just kind of thought about was a myth. It's like, man, it's almost like these things just fail
after a few years. But now it actually is. Things conveniently happen in a way where you think, like, man, it really does seem like the DNC is conspiring against Bernie Sanders, and then all it takes is, just, like, a few leaked emails. Oh, maybe it seemed that way because it is that way. Wow.
Maybe the Earth is flat.
Just
fucking globalists. Sorry, retards. Sorry that I know the truth. I'm just a truther. So, when it comes to college, university, and everything like that, there is some merit there, for sure. It's just, but here's the thing, like, if you want to learn a certain field, I'd say study. Like, the internet's free, and it's like the information is almost like
well, yeah,
endless.
Exactly. The information that you could possibly get from a college course is available
yeah.
already, right? You can find it. You can find the textbooks online,
if
right?
If it wasn't, for...
you can purchase the textbooks themselves.
Yeah.
The only thing a professor does. Is motivate you if you just wouldn't be doing it otherwise. And if you wouldn't be doing it otherwise and you're not motivated, then why are you doing it?
Take
if you don't really
course. Want
to be doing it and you need somebody to basically coax you through it
yeah.
the entire thing in order for you to actually learn anything or get anything out of it,
then
why are you doing it?
Yeah.
If you need the piece of paper at the end of it, then go to a college and you
yeah.
spent like thousands, tens of thousands of dollars on the piece of paper that should hopefully get you a job where you can make that money back.
Exactly, exactly. So the thing is like, just from the internet alone, just from YouTube, no film school, Vimeo, I've learned so much about like filmmaking. It's ridiculous, about cameras, about techniques, about how to, like, just like, I'll just type in, how do I get this shot? What do I need to do that emulate this shot? What equipment do I need? It's like, the information is just all there. Where I know, like, the stupid thing is, like, if I went to film school right now, I would be getting a lot of the same information that I just already know. But, like, but still, there is some merit to going to film school in the sense that, like, you get hands-on training, which the internet doesn't provide. Like you,
oh yeah, networking. That, sorry,
and
I'm
networking.
Reading comments too. Yeah, networking would be the what I would get the most out of from a college or university for sure. I would have more faith in our colleges and universities if they weren't a hotbed for hive mind, groupthink, anti-intellectualism. You know. If these places weren't like some of the worst places that you could possibly be if you wanted to avoid mob mentality and crazy anti-intellectualism, then I would have more respect for them, and I would assume like, oh yeah, so qualifications do matter, and only smart people get in, and you actually learn something from the experience, and et cetera, et cetera. Like, I guess if you're an intelligent person going into one of these institutions, then obviously you're going to get a lot more out of it than just some random Joe or just some random person who's like, well, this is the next step in my life. I got to go to university. I don't know what I'm doing, but I guess I got to do it. I'm going to go into gender studies. Ah, damn it. I don't have a job in the STEM fields. Damn it. What happened?
Oh, man.
Ah, but now I learned all about why I don't have a job in the STEM fields, and it's because of institutional sexism. Oh,
dang
my God.
It.
Yeah, the fact that's in college and university is like gender studies. Come on,
that's a joke.
Like that's you can't. It's so embarrassing.
Where's my reptilian like studies? Where's my reptilian studies in fucking college? If we're gonna have like gender studies, ugh. Come on. Let's talk about flat Earth theory. In school. Let's have a program for flat Earth, like, flat earthers. Please. Because if we're gonna have gender studies, and they're just gonna be like, women and black people are systemically... fuck it. It's so stupid. It just bugs me when this stuff, like, when, like, Anita Sarkeesian makes it to the UN, when, like, mansplaining and manspreading makes it to the dictionary, when, like, gender studies makes it to colleges and universities. It's like, and like the best part is like when a lot of people complain, it's like, oh man, this way of thinking is gonna like really fuck up everything. And people are like, wow, these man babies think that like feminism is gonna ruin like shit for them. And it does. It ruins video games. It ruins arguments, like legitimate arguments, because it's like, oh, you're just a mansplainer. Let me shut you down completely.
This is it.
Yes, we will offer the copy of our.
I
want to
die.
It will delete all
Kill me.
Of the virus.
I'm triggered. Why can't we have rat studies? Why aren't we studying the rats?
The heretics will respond with force to our upload. We must
actually
hold this room.
Thinking about rats, I think about like how they would grow like human parts off of like rats, like that one rat, that famous rat where they grew a human ear and then grafted it onto somebody who had their ear like they were born without an ear or something, or got removed or something, or like taken off in a war or something like that, or like damaged. And I remember talking to somebody, it's like, we were having a conversation about, like, growing meat, essentially. And they were like, oh, yeah, I can't wait for a future where we're, like, growing meat and everything. We don't have to, like, you know, I would stop being vegan for, like, if they, you know, we stopped, like, hurting these animals and stuff. Like, that's the whole point. I'm like this. And I was like, yeah, it actually does sound kind of great. But, you know, the downside is they grow all the meat off of rats. They grow it off the backs of rats, and then they sever it, and then we eat the rat meat. And they're like, oh my god. It's like, well, I mean, but we're still saving all these animals. And there's like, ethically, there's nothing wrong with doing that to a rat. It's not like it's torture. And it's like, you know.
It's just a dirty rat.
It's like, and I asked them, it's like, would you still eat like the meat if it was drawn off the back of a rat? And they're like, oh, I don't know anymore. It's like, no, that's not how it's done. It's like growing a test tube. But it was really funny how, like, they changed it to, like, the second I was like, oh, yeah, you have to grow the meat off of rats.
Heretic runtime's downloading to mobile platforms.
What? Why Oblivion? Stop. Rat lives matter. Why is everyone just saying rat lives matter?
Fuck.
What do you learn in philosophy? Do you just learn about, like, great
philosophers? I like the concept of philosophy, although I can't... I think philosophy would be a more legitimate study than psychology, honestly.
I thought he was a guess.
Philosophy... So, like, moral philosophy is the discussion of, like, what's right and wrong.
Yeah.
Right? So that's... When I'm having a conversation about whether or not bestiality is okay, that's an example of moral philosophy, right? Yeah. Even though people just don't really understand how to have a conversation about moral philosophy, apparently.
But I also feel like the term philosophy in a college setting... the term philosophy is a little bit vague and kind of encompassing of a lot of things. But I think that if you were to take a course on it, there's a good chance that you might actually not be studying what you would want or intended to get out of it. So I can actually see how philosophy is literally kind of like psychology in the sense that, like, it could just be, like, academic, like, dicking around in terms of, like, courses and studies go. Not saying that, actually, then again, I'm not saying psychology is dicking around. It's literally there for people who take it seriously and want to go all the way with it. It's like, why would you get a doctorate in anything if you weren't going to actually get, like, would you, like, it's literally the equivalent of somebody, like, learning to be, like, become a, like, getting the same, taking the same studies as, like, a surgeon would. And then passing, and then going working at Starbucks for the rest of their life. And they're like, by the way, if I wanted to, I could surgically remove your organs and then safely. So I think I know more about this issue than you do. It's like essentially what they're doing.
The issue is how to surgically remove an organ.
Yeah. Then that's that one time they can chime in and be like, guess what? I'm actually smarter than you because I paid half attention to my teacher and studied half as well as the rest of the students in my class about how to properly remove an organ from a body and implant another.
Yeah.
What else to worry about? Oh my god. Froggy's on a warpath.
What is Froggy doing?
Froggy's calling people out.
Shepherd Commander, oh. It is time to choose. Do we rewrite the heretics or delete them?
Aw.
But why?
Whoever Froggy is talking to, I take Froggy's side. Has the right to make because it's Froggy, decisions. And she's a mod.
The heretics chose a path
she's my mod.
Coexistence.
You're letting them make their decisions, then killing them for it? You can't have it both ways, Legion.
Their choice was to remove our right to make decisions.
I'm gonna go piss from my boy pussy. I'll be right back.
What's to stop them from using the virus?
What should I do, guys?
We will delete the virus after using it. We judge it too dangerous to allow its existence.
Why are you letting me make this decision? They're your people.
We are conflicted. There is no consensus among our higher order runtimes. 573 favor rewrite and 571 favor destruction. Shepherd Commander, You have fought the heretics. You have perspective we lack. The Geth grant their fate to you.
Okay.
If they're rewritten, your people will accept them back? Will they even want to go back?
They will agree with our judgments in return. We will integrate their experiences. All will be stronger.
Take them then. When we get control of them, release the virus.
Acknowledged. Releasing virus. Note, remote access via high gain transmission required.
That sounds ominous.
The virus will be sent to heretics in nearby star systems. This station will broadcast a powerful electromagnetic pulse through FTL channels.
How powerful?
Yield in excess of 1.21 petawatts. Alert. EM flux will be hazardous to unshielded organic forms.
Oh.
Addendum. The interior of this station is not shielded.
I really wish you'd said that before. Back to the ship. Double time, people.
All right, double time. Where we go? The people say me crazy, but they don't even know me. Because I take showers?
Turn that shit off.
Alright, how long of it? When should I set my timer for after I take a shower to turn my fan off?
You have a private shower. Just shower with the door open.
What?
Shower with the door open. Or a window open. That's all you need, actually.
I should be able to use my fan.
Yeah, but turn it off, because it's annoying for me.
Can you still hear it with the closet, like, closed, or have you tried it out yet? Because I've turned my fan off, pretty much every single night. Well, just because you can hear it when you wake up doesn't mean that it's keeping you awake, right?
No, I mean, like, that's like you had it on all night.
Like, so you're awake all night?
No, but it does bug me. Sometimes it's more so than usual. If I go to bed with a headache, it's like it intensifies it for sure. I think that me asking you to just like turn off the fan.
I do it when I remember.
Minimal like effort.
It is
stuff for something.
Which is why it's done when I remember. Like.
I'm gonna start messaging when you say you're gonna go to bed. I'm gonna start like sending you a quick text or something and be like, fuck your fan.
If I have a shower in the middle of the night, I want to be able to not have my bathroom be like entirely soggy, you know?
Why are so many frogs? Roommate fight.
There. Oh, we gotta get out of here. Gas pistol though. Alright. Let's leave.
Oh no. I definitely jump up in like Twitter followers whenever we do one of these streams.
All right. I think it's a good time to change games, probably.
Okay.
I might be able to sex Garrus right now. Let's see.
Commander Tali just went to have a chat with Legion. You better get down to the AI core.
I'm on it, Joker.
Oh, no!
Shepard, I'm glad you're here. I caught Legion scanning my Omni-tool. It was going to send data about the flotilla back to the Geth.
Creators performed weapons tests and were discussing plans to attack us. We believed it necessary to warn our people.
We already made the Geth stronger by rewriting the ones that worship the Reapers. I won't let Legion endanger the fleet by giving them more information.
Creator Tali Zora acts out of loyalty to her people. She was willing to be exiled to protect them. We must also protect our people from the Creator threat.
You can't let this happen, Shepard. I trusted you, and I worked with a Geth on the team, but this is too much.
Yeah,
knock this crap off.
This is exactly what the Reapers want. Tali, of course the Geth are worried about your people. You want to destroy them.
It's not that simple.
Sounds pretty simple.
Are you trying to undermine this entire operation?
We did not intend to decrease operational efficiency.
We're on a mission. You can either fight at my side or get crushed under my heel, but you will not stand in my way.
To facilitate unit cohesion, we will not transmit data regarding Creator plans.
Thank you, Legion. I understand your intention. What if I gave you some non-classified data to send?
We would be grateful.
Yeah. Aw. Hoagie Shepard, man.
Alright, let's see if,
Oh, I think I get it now.
What?
So the Geth are Jews, and Tali... The Normandy is the Gaza Strip. I'm sorry. The mindless robots are Jews. Mark said it. They're a hive mind, just like Jews. And Woody Allen is the hive queen. You must destroy him in order to shut down all the Jews. Alright!
Yeah, I keep killing all my fish. Because I never remember to feed them, or I'll feed them too much. Well.
What do you mean by Mark should be a critic? A critic of what? Because I don't like being a critic. I don't think I'd, I'm critical, but I don't think I'd ever, like, sit down and be like, hey, guys, listen to me voice my opinions about this shit. I'll keep it for the stream, but, like, I don't want to actually make a channel about, like, my actual opinions.
I suggest you take the shuttle to access your next location.
The shuttle? Okay, I can do that.
I'd like to create things, not criticize them. Like, professionally, I guess you could say.
What?
That is not entirely accurate, Mr. Moreau. The device is powered, but it is causing some unusual instability in other systems. I recommend a more thorough analysis before we attempt to use it.
We can't put our mission on hold forever. How long will this take?
Full scan? Who knows with this thing? Maybe you better take the shuttle for this mission. I'll make sure we're up and running when you get back.
Okay.
Closer to our destination, you can decide who to take with you.
All right.
I'm on my way. Joker, the ship is yours. Don't scratch the paint.
Aye, aye, Commander.
But where am I going?
Damn, girl, that booty.
Oh, I like booze. It's cherry cola.
I'm telling you, Edie, your readings are off. It's radiation bleed, just white noise.
I have detected a signal embedded in the static. We are transmitting the Normandy's location.
Transmitting? To who?
Ah!
Oh, shit!
reflector ship?
We're getting out of here!
Propulsion systems are disabled. I'm detecting a virus in the ship's computers.
From the IFF? Damn it, why didn't you scrub it?
Primary defense systems are offline. We can save the Normandy, Mr. Moreau, but you must help me. Give me the ship.
What? You're crazy! You start singing Daisy Bell and I'm done.
Unlock my sealed databases and I can...
2001 reference.
The maintenance shaft in the science lab will allow passage to the AI core. Main corridors are no longer safe. The collectors have boarded. The emergency floor lighting will guide you, Mr. Moreau.
God damn it.
What?
Emergency lighting. Gotta go.
Isn't Joker, like...
disabled, pretty much.
Really?
That's why I can't really run. Barely. Go, 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 go.
Hurry, Joker, go!
Why does he have to run to this part of the ship to, like...
Shit.
Man, if only I didn't have a supple glass-like body. It's almost like I should have been military and physically fit in order to pilot the ship.
Multiple hostiles detected on the crew deck.
All right.
Joker! This deck is crawling with those things. Stay close.
This is literally like the worst case scenario that somebody should have brought up when it came to like whether or not Joker should have been a pilot. It's like, oh, what if in an emergency situation you have to like get off your get out of your seat and do something? Oh no, I'm a crippled baby.
I'm a big boy.
All right, I'm at you.
To the Normandy's primary control module.
She sounds so calm.
This is where it starts. We're just all organic batteries. Guess who they'll blame? This is all Joker's fault. What a tool he was. I have to spend all day computing Pi because he plugged in the Overlord.
How am I not seeing what?
I have access to the defensive systems. Thank you, Mr. Moreau. Now you must reactivate the primary drive in engineering.
You want me to go crawling through the ducts again?
I enjoy the sight of humans on their knees. That is a joke.
Right.
Behind you connects to the engineering.
All right.
Good luck.
Oh, when are Joker and Edie just gonna fuck already? All this sexual tensions drive my dick crazy.
Hostiles are present in engineering. They are heading towards the cargo
Shit.
Bay.
Let me go.
Oh, this is a scary game.
Sorry.
Engineering is activate the drive and I will open the airlocks as we accelerate. All hostiles will be killed.
What? What about the crew?
They are gone, Jeff. The collectors took them.
Oh, shit.
Fuck.
I am sealing the engine room. I have control.
Ow!
Purge is complete. No other life forms on board. Securing airlocks and cargo bay doors.
No, like, actually, what's wrong with Joker? Like, why is he like this?
He's got, like, some sort of cripple baby problem.
Send a message to Shepard.
I think it's like
Shuttle.
His back.
Tell her what happened.
Message away. Are you feeling well, Jeff?
No. But thanks for asking.
His legs. Well, I don't know what Mission Shepherd did, but I'm sure it was important. She comes back after, like, dancing. Hey, she's got, like, three collector's fish and, like, everyone and like expensive fish and, like, model ship toys.
Not his fault, Miranda.
Just a bunch under her arms. And, like, what the fuck, Joker?
The data in the collector drive was even more sophisticated than the black box Reaper viruses I was given.
I heard it was a rough ride. How you holding up?
There's a lot of empty chairs in here.
We did everything we could, Jeff.
Yeah. Thanks, Mom.
We'll determine fault later. Is the ship operational?
Oh, you just called her Mom. Online. Now there's a peak in the sexual tension. Freudian slip.
Don't even get me started about unshackling a damned AI.
Well, what can I do against collectors? Break my arm at them? Edie cleared the ship. She's all right.
I assure you, I am still bound by protocols in my programming. Even if I were not, you are my crewmates.
What's your assurance worth? Your loyalty rests on the flip of a quantum bit.
Loyalty is rooted in mutual respect, common experience, and common cause. We share two of those.
Save it for philosophy night. I vote we rescue the crew.
We've done everything we can. It's time to take the fight to the collectors.
Not quite yet.
I want to dance some more.
I gotta get my pussy filled with some Turian goop.
Hit the map whenever you're ready, Commander.
Ooh, the secret of the ooze.
The bone of scone.
I want to see Garrus's bone of scone. I want to find out the secret to his ooze.
Shepard, how can I help?
Let's talk about...
Upgrades. Okay, I'm gonna go get something.
Some what?
I'm gonna get something. Don't you worry about that little boy.
Upgrades seem feasible. Can install them whenever you like.
I'm gonna ask him about Garrus, though.
Yes, we'd like that, actually. Talked about work earlier. Time with special tasks group studying Genophage. It wasn't entirely honest. Lie of omission. Also, other kinds need to clear the air. Mission too important to keep secrets. Work on Genophage was more than just study.
I had a feeling you were holding
something
back.
Wasn't. Krogan population was increasing at faster rate than expected. First created new version of Genophage.
You were protecting the lab.
Should get back to work. Talk more later.
I got so many renegade points for a conversation I could have sworn I already had. Okay, I'm just gonna see if the option to fuck Garrus is up there yet. Bah. No. Nope, not yet. I gotta, like, talk to him. What do I gotta do to fuck Garrus? Maybe I gotta do more planet scanning. Start the suicide mission? Yeah, I think... Okay, yeah, that's what I thought. I just forgot if it was just like a non-stop thing until the end of the game where I didn't even get a chance after that point. Because sometimes it's like when you do it, when you have an option in a game and you know that it's like coming up to the end of it, you want to make sure that like that doesn't remove, that it doesn't just automatically go all the way until the end and then you don't have the chance for something again. But yeah, I think you're right. Oh shit! I finally found some Element Zero. This is what I've been looking for. Oh boy. Jeez. Boy cheese. Oh.
Launching probe.
Oh. Yeah, boy. The Retrain Powers Research Project, huh? All that element zero, boy. So happy. It's the planet I wanted. Apparently, men can produce milk. Apparently.
Probe launched. Probe away.
I will switch games very soon, don't worry.
Probe away.
My boy pussy. All right. Okay, time to save. Alright, I'm gonna... Oh, more sandwich! I'm gonna exit this game, we're gonna start something else. Hey!